Hello everyone, and welcome to the Epic Flight Academy. Today, we will discuss steep turns. The keys to success for this maneuver are, number one, complete your A squared, B squared, C squared checklist. Number two, good pitch control on the roll in and the roll out. Number three, maintain a constant bank angle and a constant altitude. We're not so concerned about radius or a ground reference point in this maneuver. Number four, adjust the trim and the power as needed. Number five, maintain coordination throughout the maneuver in turns both to the left and to the right. Number six, use a distant reference to maintain your orientation. Number seven, maintain traffic vigilance during the turn. Number eight, lead your rollout by half your bank angle. And number nine, roll out on the distant point or the designated heading. And remember, from our commercial video on the keys that apply to all the commercial maneuvers, smooth and positive inputs on the flight controls with constant small corrections. And this is not an instrument maneuver. You must be looking outside ahead of your airplane when performing steep turns. Now, references for this maneuver will not be the way that I do it, or the way my instructor showed me way back when, or any specific flight school's method, but rather the Airplane Flying Handbook 8083-3 Charlie. By the way, the Epic Flight Academy Standardization Manual follows the Aircraft Flying Handbook 8083-3 Charlie. Please open this Airplane Flying Handbook to Chapter 10, Page 1, and follow along as I walk you through the maneuver. The maneuver may be one 360-degree turn or two 360s for a 720-degree turn, and it is to be done in both directions. The goal here is to develop smoothness, feel, and coordination, while at the same time divide your attention between the maneuver and the surrounding area, scanning for traffic and other hazards. Please see other Epic Flight Academy videos to review the factors and forces in a turning airplane, and remember that of the three primary flight controls, it is the elevator that turns the airplane. While the fundamental concepts of all turns are the same, in this maneuver, the pilot is exposed to several very important concepts. First, higher G-forces. Second, the overbanking tendency. Third, the loss of the vertical component of lift in a steep bank. Fourth, substantial pitch control pressures. And fifth, the need for added power to maintain a constant altitude. Regardless of airspeed, for a given bank angle in a level turn, the same load factor will always be produced. A pilot may have some difficulty with orientation and movement when first experiencing these forces. So for this reason, it is critical that the pilot maintain orientation to a distant ground reference object, as we show here in Figure 10-1. Because of the higher load factors, steep turns should be performed at an airspeed that does not exceed the airplane's design maneuvering speed, or VA, and at an airspeed high enough to allow for a good stall speed margin. So, what's a good speed for this maneuver? Well, let's start with stalling speed. If you are flying a Cessna 172S, please turn to Chapter 5 of your POH or PIM and refer to the stall speed table. Notice that the table shows speeds for most rearward and most forward CG, gross weight, and power at idle. Now, specific conditions will change, but please notice that the indicated stall speed shown on the chart with flaps up goes from 48 to 76 knots. That is an increase of 28 knots from wings level to a 60-degree bank. So, to round off for safety, let's just think about a 30-knot increase in stall speed at a 60-degree bank. Next, think about your VA speed as you practice this maneuver. Of course, at gross weight, our VA is 105, but at 2,200 pounds, it is approximately 98 knots. So, by entering our steep turn at 95 knots, we are establishing a safe margin above the increased stalling speed and below the decreased maneuvering speed. So, to begin the maneuver, complete your A squared, B squared, C squared checklist. This will ensure a good, safe entry to the turns. But be aware that you must continually clear the area throughout the conduct of your turns. Now, you have a prominent visual reference point, and you've stabilized the aircraft at 95 knots. Start by rolling the aircraft into a stable turn. Be sure to master the sight picture for your bank angle because you do not want to be looking inside at the PFD during this maneuver. You're going to have to anticipate the large amount of back pressure that will be required to stabilize the turn at a constant altitude. Also, when you reach your steep turn bank angle, you will have to anticipate the overbanking tendency. Now, a good technique for this is to roll into the turn saying to yourself, 10, 20, 30, pull, 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 power, trim, trim, trim. You call out 10, 20, 30 for the bank angle as you roll into and past them, and then pull, pull, pull is the reminder that you'll need much more back pressure as you roll past 30 degrees of bank. Power is the reminder that we must add power. In order to maintain altitude at a constant airspeed, the pilot increases the angle of attack to ensure that the vertical component of lift is sufficient to maintain altitude. Recall that some of the lift has been vectored off to the horizontal to make the aircraft turn. As you roll in, you will have to add some power. In the Cessna 172S, this will be approximately 100 RPM, but conditions will vary, so please work with your flight instructor. Then, trim, trim, trim is a reminder that three full movements on the trim wheel, or three handfuls, will be the approximate amount of trim required. Again, this will vary and require practice. A full movement of the trim wheel means grabbing it at the top and moving it all the way down, or grabbing it at the bottom and moving it all the way up, depending if you want nose up or nose down trim. This is a full movement, as we show here, and is commonly called a handful. Do this about 3 times. The exact amount will vary, so practice with your flight instructor. A common question when it comes to steep turns is, should I do these with trim or without trim? Now, our advice is, don't be trapped into answering this as an either-or question. Our answer is, do it both ways. With trim is a good technique, and if you're maintaining the turn for, say, 360 degrees or more, trim makes it easier to maintain the turn altitude. But what if you want a steep turn for just 60 or 90 or maybe 120 degree heading change? Or what if you experience a trim system failure? You'll want to have the feel of the airplane, both with and without using trim. Now, as you roll and your bank steepens, the aircraft will be ready, willing, and able to just keep right on rolling. This is because the outside wing is now traveling at a noticeably greater speed than the inside wing, and as a result, making more lift. Now, that outside wing will roll the airplane right over, unless the pilot stops it. So, you'll have to put in some opposite aileron here. And notice, you will be cross-controlled. This is both normal and correct. At this point, you'll have to know and establish your visual sight pictures and hold them. Also at this point, you'll notice an increased G-load. Now, this may be your first time experiencing an increased G-load in the aircraft, and so you'll have to practice and get used to it so that you can continue to maintain your orientation and situational awareness. Now, to roll out of the steep turn. This too takes some planning and practice. A good rollout depends upon keeping a consistent sight picture and looking outside ahead of where your aircraft is flying. You'll want to lead your rollout by approximately half of your bank angle. What this means is, let's say you're conducting a steep turn at a 60-degree bank angle. You'll want to lead your rollout by one half of that, or by 30 degrees of heading. To accomplish this, you will have been looking outside ahead of the aircraft. And 30 degrees before your prominent landmark, you start the rollout. Now, see the points that we've added to figure 10-1 from the Airplane Flying Handbook. And if the turn is at 50 degrees, lead the rollout by 25 degrees of heading, and so on. As you roll out, reverse what you said before, and this time it's 50-40-30, push, 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 reduce power, trim, trim, trim. Once you're accustomed to the G-load, cross-controlled condition, and the sight picture, you can start to maintain your bank angle and altitude consistently. Once you can do this, then practice holding your steep turn through 2 complete circuits around the compass, or what we call a 720-degree steep turn. Maintaining bank angle, altitude, and orientation requires an awareness of the relative position of the horizon to the nose and the wings. A pilot who references the aircraft's attitude by observing only the nose will have difficulty maintaining altitude. To master the maneuver, you must observe both the nose and the wings relative to the horizon. In a Cessna 172S, you'll notice that your sight picture will be different because of the side-by-side seating. Now, be sure to practice your steep turns to the left and to the right. From either direction, practice holding the turn for 720 degrees and then roll right through wings level and directly into a steep turn in the other direction and hold that turn for 720 degrees. Once you start to master these skills, you'll see that the steep turn is very fun and can be done safely. Well, folks, that wraps up steep turns. Have fun, fly safe, and we'll see you next time.